So you know what makes this week's car so special? After a good workout, there's a built-in water bowl in case you forgot to pack one. All right, look, I know, not the original intent, but look at this thing. It's weather sealed. You can actually swap this out for a refrigerated compartment. Yeah, crazy. Actually, thinking about it, there are a ton of dog-friendly features in this 2021 Land Rover Defender. Today, it's gonna be a hot mess. I'm gonna wear this sleeping bag to keep me warm. In addition to my multiple layers, unfortunately, one of my mittens already blew away. So, okay, let's just jump right into it. This cargo space is honestly perfectly fitted for a dog. Take a good look at that thing. There's not an ounce of carpet. Everything's nice and hard, and look at the texture of that floor. You don't even need a vacuum. You can just blow it and it looks clean. On top of that, you could get rubber floor mats, which I'll get to some accessories later on in the video. But overall, this design is a huge win if you have a dog that sheds. And look up. You see these windows? They're called Alpine lights. It's like you have skylights in your cargo space. Between those and the panel moonroof, there is just so much natural light in this rear. And don't be critical and say, well, that's just gonna be too much sunlight. Your dog's gonna get hot back there, because guess what? Boo-hoo! There's rear climate in the cargo area. That's right, you have third row climates, because you could get this with the third row, but even though we don't have one in here, it's still present. Ah! It's called three-zone climate control with rear cooling assist. And it's just over $1,000. And with the addition of an outlet right here, airflow will never be an issue. And it gets better. Look at these buttons right here. You got air suspension, making entering and exiting so much easier. And once you're loaded and ready to go, that's a 40-20-40 split. So just plop down that middle section and your dog can see forward and you can see them more easily. The only thing you need to be careful about is the hardware, because it definitely juts out. It would be nice if they made some sort of rubber piece that you could put over it, but we know how to fix that. Pop. All right, leave it. It's not for play, it's for safety. When you fold down these seats, I just want to note that they don't go fully flat. That would have been the icing on the cake. But what are you gonna do? There is some underfloor storage back there. And to be honest, there's a bunch of spots that you can just stow things away throughout this vehicle. Like the entire dashboard, for example. Look at this. There's storage across the entire thing, even behind the infotainment screen. And the center console, which you got a sneak peek of earlier, I love how open it is with multiple access points. And as I referenced, you can swap this out with a refrigerated compartment for $300 US. Or for 900 bucks, you can take this entire center out and replace it with a jump seat. I definitely have mixed thoughts about the jump seat. Before I got this, in my mind, I thought that would be so cool. I'd love to have that. But in actuality, after looking at the pictures, it doesn't look that comfortable. It's shorter than these seats, and personally, I just wouldn't want to lose out on all this utility. I mean, maybe if I had a small dog, I'd consider it, but then it would block my view to the back. Speaking of seat configuration, as is, this is a five-seater. But like I mentioned, you could get this with a third row. But in my opinion, this is the best spec for a dog. And the seats, they're pretty comfortable too. Lots of lumbar support if you like that, and they're beautiful. It's got the rugged look, but it still feels luxury. And the exposed bolts, hardware, whatever you want to call it, I think it totally works. But something really exciting about this 2021 model is that it has the new infotainment system, which they call Pivi Pro. It's way more intuitive, easier to use, and according to Land Rover, this new layout reduces the number of steps by an average of 50% versus previous Land Rover systems. It also has wireless charging, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and I've had no difficulty connecting. I especially love the cameras in here. Check out this 3D perspective. You can see the surrounding area, narrow in on a particular area, look at the front, back wheels. So if you're off-roading or going through, I don't know, your favorite fast food line, you'll have the extra visual and not have to worry about hitting a curb or running over anything. The buttons are multifunction like we've seen before, so you can change the temperature, your seat warmer, the fan speed. And once you get used to it, it really makes a lot of sense. It keeps everything clean, but you can also easily access the second and third row too. By the way, that second row, it's comfortable, great leg room, the floor is essentially flat, and Abby has really enjoyed riding back there. And also, you can find some great spots to tether your dog's harness. So in terms of driving dynamics, the Defender X uses the 3-liter turbocharged inline six that produces 395 horsepower and an amazing 406 pound-feet of torque. The lower trims are going to come with a 4-liter turbo, and while it will be less money, I just honestly don't feel like it's going to match the character of this Defender as well. Acceleration is really smooth, braking, it feels adequate. The only thing that I've had a little bit of trouble with, honestly, is this gear shifter going from reverse to drive. Only that combination, for some reason, I feel like it gets stuck sometimes. The truth is, this is an electronic shifter anyway, so it's just one program modification from making it feel normal. But come on, we have got to talk about this exterior color combination. Eiger gray with the gloss black accents, black roof. So many people have stopped to look at this in part because they don't really know what it is and they love it. Lots of textures, unique design elements, like the X pattern on the black inserts on the hood, the trim pieces on the grille, and the headlights and taillights look so good. This is just one of those vehicles that when you look at it, you can't help but smile. And speaking of smiling, I have to say, seeing how comfortable Abby and Andy are back there has made me feel even better. So the base price of this Defender X is $83,000. This one all in is just shy of $86,000. Now look, I know I get a lot of flack for always doing expensive vehicles, the high trim levels, but did you know that there's a Jeep Wrangler for this price point? You get a Hellcat engine, which I know can be a lot of fun, but in this case, when you spend 86 grand, you're getting a lot. And I think that's where Land Rover really hit a home run. It's not a G-Wagon, but you'd be hard pressed to find something that has this sort of luxury with the tech updates and utility. When Lexus updates the GX460, which is technically the next closest option, maybe things will be a little different. By all means, that's still a good vehicle and you can head to our video to check that out. But nothing like this Defender. It has such a unique look, and those shopping in this segment that want to go off-roading, it's honestly hard not to justify. And if you're a pet owner, they offer a lot of different accessories that you can add to your purchase. The Pet Care and Access Pack is $1,851, but there's some things in it that really just don't make a lot of sense for me. It does include the portable rinse system though, which I would definitely want, but I don't need the ramp, the quilted cargo liner. It's beautiful, but it doesn't have zippers, so if you fold down the center, it's not gonna work. So instead, I'd go more a la carte. I'd get the rubber mats, the second row seat protectors, and of course, that portable rinse system. So I think it's pretty clear that this is dog friendly, but let's make it official. Hey, Andy, is the 2021 Land Rover Defender lab approved? Yes, it's totally lab approved. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, follow us on Instagram and Twitch, and we'll see you next time with another lab tested review. Bye.